Alright, welcome everybody. Happy 2021. Thank goodness that 2020 is behind us. Starting with the first video of the new year, of course, we're going to do with another tier list. This time talking about one of the most celebrated, one of the most influential hip-hop groups ever. The unfortunately now defunct A Tribe Called Quest. Going over their discography, their 6 albums, where do they rank on this personal tier list? I am a huge Tribe Called Quest fan. Probably you have seen a couple of my videos that have a shirt of A Tribe Called Quest. So should be fun to take a look at all these albums and see where they rank. So let's get into it. Starting with their first album, People's Instinctive Travels. In the Passive Rhythm, came out in 1990. I can understand how people would have said that this was a fresh new group coming out the gate. You know, they were part of the whole Native Tongues posse with De La Soul and Jungle Brothers, and they were bringing a new flavor, a new energy to hip-hop because they were using dense sampling, experimenting with different genres. They weren't always talking about, you know, violence and, you know, they were talking about positivity was their main thing. And De La Soul came out a year earlier. Jungle Brothers came out a year before that. And, you know, their debut albums are very critically acclaimed. You know, A Tribe Called Quest debut album didn't quite set the world on fire like 3 Feet High and Rising did. But it's close. I think that this is a very solid debut album. I will admit, it does sound very dated at times. Some of the lyrics don't hold up as much. I believe Fife wasn't really a part of this group when this album came out. He does have some features there, but he's not as present as he would be in later Tribe albums. So it does feel kind of like a Q-Tip solo record in some respects. Of course, with some contributions to Jairobi White, but you know, there are some classic songs here, obviously. Can I Kick It? Incredible song. Benito Applebaum, You Gotta Turn Me On. I Left My Wallet in El Segundo. I mean, these are just hip-hop staples, but there are some songs here that are, you know, very dated, very corny. You know, Tribe was a very playful kind of a group. It was a different energy, but sometimes that playfulness can lend to some bad lyrics, some bad ideas here and there. But on the whole, very ambitious, showcased the group at their best, kind of setting the template for what they would expand on in their career. So I'm going to put this in the B tier, The Low End Theory, which came out just a year later, 30 years ago this year, actually. And, I mean, look, what can I say about this album that hasn't already been said? Let me just take away the suspense. I'm putting this in the S tier. I mean, everybody's talked about this album, why it's so great, the samples, the way that it uses jazz and hip-hop and blends it in a very tasteful and nuanced way, the live instrumentation, the lyrics, the songs. I mean, what the hell can I say? This is one of the greatest hip-hop albums of all time. And really, you know, like I said, Fife coming to his own in this group, his chemistry with Q-Tip was phenomenal, especially Check the Rhyme and We Got the Jazz. I mean, just those songs really demonstrate why Tribe was such a dynamic and cohesive group. Especially at this time, they were just firing all cylinders. The way this album starts, and then the way that it ends with Scenario, one of the greatest posse cuts of all time, introduces a young Busta Rhymes, who I think steals the show here. I mean, I can't. This album is incredible. What do you want me to say? So, yes, definitely in the S tier. The next album, and my personal favorite Tribe album, Midnight Marauders. There's no weak songs here. And although I respect Low End Theory, it's a phenomenal album, there are a couple of songs that don't really hold up, a couple of lyrics that don't really hold up, but Midnight Marauders, phenomenal album. For me, it's one of the best hip-hop albums I ever heard. And a lot of people would say it's one of the best hip-hop albums ever made. Tribe, at this point, was just untouchable. There's just so much in this album that I could talk about. Just how every song just flows to the next. The sequencing is amazing. And Q-Tip just really stepping up his game with the production. Just very immaculate. I feel like Tribe at this point, you know, of course they had the underground audience, the backpackers, but this is when they started to get some commercial acclaim. And, you know, what made Tribe so special is that, you know, if you were street, you were into Tribe. If you're intellectual, you're into Tribe. If you're in college and, you know, you got the college audience, you got the alternative audience. White people love Tribe, Black people love Tribe, Latino people love Tribe. I mean, Tribe was one of those groups that just appealed to everybody. And I think it was that everyman aesthetic that both Fife and Q-Tip had, and how they were so different, you know, especially at this time when West Coast hip-hop was dominating, Dr. Dre and Snoop were dominating the rap scene, and of course Wu-Tang was just around the corner, Nas, Biggie, but Tribe just seemed like a group that everybody can agree that, yeah, this was what they're doing was dope. So Midnight Marauders, gonna put it in the S tier. Just an album that I can play with no skips. Their next album, Beats, Rhymes, and Life, came out in 1996. This was actually their first album to debut at number one. And, you know, a lot of people kind of shit on this album, to be honest. Yes, I understand that it doesn't hold a candle to the first three albums, but to me, I think this is a very underrated album. I think Tribe, although they were going through some internal struggles, and yes, there are flaws in this album, I think it's still a really good album. It's definitely the darkest of their albums up to this point. Mellow production, covering serious, I think this is Tribe usually is more playful, but Tribe talking about serious issues in the Black community. So I think that's why people kind of like didn't really gravitate to this one, because it's like, oh man, it's not as fun as you know, Midnight Marauders. It's not as eclectic as Low End Theory. It's not as experimental as People's Instinct to Travels. But you know, although Beats, Rhymes, and Life, you know, does kind of have similar production, I still think there are some great jams here. Once again, the J Dilla production here. Now, I will admit, yes, there is a little too much Consequence on this album, and I think that's another reason why people kind of shit on this album. It's like, why there's like less Fife and more Consequence on this album, which I know people kind of like, were like, what the hell is this guy? Like, we want more Fife, but I still think that this is an album that I can play often. So, yes, it's not as good as the first three, but I still really like it. So I'm going to put it in the B tier, maybe B minus tier. Very slept on album. And this was at a point where Tribe really kind of cemented themselves as one of the most forward-thinking hip-hop groups at the time. All right, the next album, The Love Movement, which came out in 98. Now, this was at the time Tribe's last album, and certainly the last album that would be released where Fife was still alive. And to me, this is my least favorite Tribe album, their least essential Tribe album. It kind of was an autocorrect. You know, people didn't really like the darker themes and production of their previous album, so they're kind of like, all right, let's go back to the basics, let's do more fun songs, let's do more playful songs. But to me, you know, it doesn't really hit as hard as their previous albums. It's kind of a forgettable album to me. Like, there's still some great songs here. Find a Way, of course, another Dilla produced song. It's the standout track, and it was the single from this album, but you listen to it, and it's kind of like, you know, a little too much features. Sounded very much like, you know, kind of getting into the R&B bag, which is fine. I mean, Q-Tip would kind of take this into his solo album, kind of bling the R&B and the hip-hop. But to me, the lyrics were not as strong as their previous albums. I understand the themes, their positivity, but I just feel like they just did it better in previous albums. So for me, I'm going to put it in the C tier. It's not an album that I go back to as much as a Tribe fan, if at all. And then last but not least, We Got It From Here, Thank You For Your Service. This was their return album. Now, unfortunately, the circumstances of this album coming, Fife tragically passing away early 2016, but Tribe still finding a way to honor him and to place his voice and his lyrics throughout this album. So it didn't really feel like a tacked on album. It really felt like he was still a part of the group, even though he wasn't no longer alive. And I'll admit, when I heard that they were releasing this album, I was very worried, because we all know when these groups have these return albums, their comeback albums, sometimes it's like, it's not as good as the old stuff. But to my delight and surprise, man, what a comeback album. Maybe you can make a case that this is the greatest hip-hop comeback album of all time. Yeah, it's like they literally did not miss a beat. You know, it's like this is their best album since Midnight Marauders. And, you know, and I think they also kind of blended, you know, yes, the playfulness and the wittiness of their earliest albums, but they did tackle serious issues. You know, 2016 was a very, very political year, to say the least. And they definitely talked about that political climate. It was great to hear them come back again and come back strongly and come at a time where we really needed a group like Tribe. At this point, they're elder statesmen of hip-hop. You know, the documentary came out. We have seen their influence through guys like J. Cole, Kendrick Lamar, Joey Badass. They even give those new rappers a shout-out, which is great. And so we all know who Tribe was, and this really showed the newer generation that, yeah, Tribe was that group. This is why they're one of the best to ever do it. Way it starts with Space Program and from there on, in the features, Anderson .Paak, Jack White, and a phenomenal verse by Busta Rhymes. Even Kanye shows up here. So it's blending the past and the present and the future. One of the better hip hop albums to come out in the past 5 years. It's not as good as Low End Theory or Midnight Marauders, but for me, a nearly flawless album and a great return to form. If you're going to go out, you got to go out this way. And I thought it was great. So I'm going to put this album in the A tier. So that is my tier list for A Tribe Called Quest Discography. Let me know what you think in the comment section below. What do you think about this tier list? Where are some of your favorite Tribe Called Quest albums and songs? YouTube recommends these two other videos to check out after this one. As always, till next time, peace.